La Plaza Mayor Spanish Language Tutorials. I'm Mr. Jason Cummings.
Dos acciones en la misma frase. Puede haber dos o más acciones en la misma frase. There can be two or more actions in the same sentence. Cuando esto ocurre, los verbos pueden usarse en el mismo tiempo verbal o en tiempos distintos, dependiendo de lo que el hablante quiere decir. When this happens, the verbs can be used in the same verb tense or in different tenses, depending on what the speaker wants to say. En esta frase usamos el pretérito para los tres verbos porque los tres son acciones sencillas que empezaron y terminaron en el pasado. Es como una lista de acciones que han ocurrido.
In this sentence we use the preterite for all three verbs because all three are simple actions that began and ended in the past. It's like a list of actions that have happened.
Yo fui a la tienda, vi unas zapatillas Nike y las compré.
I went to the store, I saw some Nike sneakers, and I bought them.
These are simply three independent sentences, or sentences rather, that could appear independently.
I went to the store, I saw some sneakers, and I bought them, but they're put together in one sentence. So really, it's a conjunction of three simple sentences, all of which relay simple past actions.
Cuando se usa el imperfecto para dos o más verbos en la misma frase, hay dos razones posibles. Número uno, las dos son descripciones o acciones habituales. Cuando era pequeño, tenía el pelo rubio.
When I was small, I used to have blonde hair. The two are descriptions or habitual actions.
Ellos siempre iban al supermercado y hacían las compras.
They always used to go to the supermarket and they would do the shopping. The first sentence here, we have a description in the past. When I was young, I used to have blonde hair. In the second, we have a habitual action described in the past. They always used to go to the supermarket and they would do the shopping.
Las dos son acciones en el imperfecto. Número dos, son dos acciones simultáneas. They are two simultaneous actions. Ella cenaba y miraba la televisión.
She was eating dinner and watching the television.
Nosotros conversábamos mientras andábamos por la calle.
We were conversing while we walked down the street.
In these two sentences, each sentence has a series of actions that are occurring simultaneously.
You could have an infinite number of things going on at the same time. Describing that in the past, you would use the imperfect.
En este ejemplo, el verbo imperfecto describe el escenario y el verbo pretérito narra la acción.
In this example, the imperfect verb describes the scene and the preterite verb narrates the action.
Muchas veces el pretérito expresa una interrupción.
Many times the preterite expresses an interruption.
Andábamos por la calle cuando empezó a llover.
We were walking down the street when it began to rain.
A couple of ways of thinking of this. One is that we were walking down the street as a description of a scene in which the real information that needs to be narrated here is that it began to rain.
The important information is that it began to rain.
Another way of visualizing it or thinking of it is that it beginning to rain is an interruption. It interrupts our walking down the street. The interruption is always going to be in el pretérito.
Mr. Cummings enseñaba la clase cuando el móvil de una estudiante sonó.
Mr. Cummings was teaching the class when the cell phone of a student rang. Again, we can think of this a number of ways, that Mr. Cummings was teaching the class as a description setting the stage for the important action that needs to be narrated here, the fact that a student's cell phone rang, or we could say that sonó is an interruption which interrupts the fact that Mr. Cummings was teaching the class.
A veces es fácil visualizar este tipo de frase así.
Sometimes it's easy to visualize this type of sentence like this.
Andábamos por la calle, we were walking down the street, una acción que ocurría durante un periodo indefinido,
an action that occurred during an indefined period of time. Cuando empezó a llover, when it began to rain, una interrupción de la acción de andar, an interruption of the action of walking.
Mr. Cummings enseñaba la clase. Mr. Cummings was teaching the class, acción que ocurría durante un periodo indefinido, cuando el móvil de un estudiante sonó,
when a student's cell phone rang, la interrupción
siendo siempre un verbo en pretérito,
the interruption always being a verb in the preterite, and the thing that is interrupted being a verb in the imperfect.
Escoge la palabra que mejor completa la frase.
Número 1. Ayer por la tarde yo iba a la tienda cuando vi a un amigo mío.
Yesterday in the afternoon I was going to the store when I saw a friend of mine.
Here the verb iba is envisioned as a description. It's saying what was happening when the important thing that I came to tell you about, the fact that I saw a friend of mine, happened. Or you can think of it as an action that was ongoing and that was interrupted by the interrupting action in the preterite, I saw a friend of mine.
Número 2. Anoche, ellos estudiaban y tomaban café.
Last night, they were studying and were drinking coffee.
Now, this is envisioned as two simultaneous actions, right? They were doing the two things at once. They were studying and they were drinking coffee. If you thought of this as a sequence of estudiaron y tomaron café, it could still be correct, depending on what you wanted to say. If you were to have used the preterite here, nonetheless, it would mean that they studied, finished studying, put their books away, and got out the coffee.
Número 3.
Nosotros hicimos la tarea y después nos acostamos.
We did the homework, and afterwards we went to bed. Here, necessarily, you have to use the preterite for both because the assumption is that you did not go to bed and do the homework at the same time. One of those actions began and ended before the next one began. This is the case of a series of simple past actions that just happened to find themselves together in the same sentence.
Eran las 10 de la noche cuando tú me llamaste.
Again, this example is almost exactly like number one. It's being 10 o'clock at night is a description which sets the stage for the important thing that I came to tell you, the fact that you called me. Or you can think of it as the fact that you called me is an interrupting action which interrupted it's being 10 o'clock.
La Plaza Mayor Spanish Language Tutorials. I'm Mr. Jason Cummings.